It's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us at the London Comic Con. How have you been enjoying it so far?
Oh, it's been wonderful. I guess it's quite a bit bigger than last year. I was here a year ago, so it's exciting to see that it's grown and the fans are that much more committed, which is cool. We've kept them.
We've got great fans here in London. Have you had any particularly memorable encounters with UK fans before?
Yeah, I'm surprised that I actually recognize quite a few of the people, and that's because they really watch the show. And I find that people over here, when they're passionate, they're truly passionate, and there's a level of intelligence here that is pretty impressive. So we're having good conversations. So you're not just, you know, coming up and getting a signature and leaving. They're actually asking about our characters and what's happening in the next season. They're truly invested, so it feels like a worthwhile time.
I mean, fans clearly have responded very well to the show. What do you think it is that people all around the world have jumped onto with Falling Skies?
You know, the further along we get, the more I'm seeing that it is quite a fantastical show. It's dark, but there's that element of imagination and possibility that you get in sci-fi, and I think that has mass appeal. I think that would be the reason that we've got more alien species and the community is more complicated and there's a different set of rules that come with this new world. So you want it to keep going on and on and on because you can see that it's just going to continue to be more interesting.
And the show's certainly evolved and grown, like you say, as it's gone along. I think the second season kind of opened up the world and took it to another level, and I think we're hoping very much the third season is going to continue that. I guess the first question fans are going to want to know, what can we expect from season three and how excited are you about it?
I'm very excited about season three. I think the show has changed a lot this season, and that's because, as we saw at the end of season two, there's a new alien that's introduced, Cochise, played by Doug Jones, who's just wonderful. And, you know, that just changes everything because we really are living and working with alien allies. So, you know, I think the show is this more human, nomadic tribe, army, and now it's, you know, the Volm weapons and, you know, the skitters are more complicated. There's really the, you know, the ones that you can trust and who's for us, who's against us, what are we really building. There's a lot more action, I guess, this season, and the relationships are deeper and clearer. And I don't know if this is going to be controversial to say because it's definitely my opinion, but I think, and this is in a good way, it's become more like a great, I want to say cartoon, but you know, like those awesome caricatures that we all kind of relate to and just kind of get the imagination going in a way that doesn't when you're just in a normal human drama. You can tell I'm like totally into it.
I think obviously the aliens present a tapestry of different characters, but I think the human cast, the human characters we have in the show are of course fascinating in themselves. Talking about yours specifically, how do you think she's changed and what excites you so much about playing this particular role?
I'm glad you like the human characters. That's good. I absolutely love playing Maggie. She's taught me so much as a person just because she's doesn't care what anybody else thinks. She's got a courageous heart and she, you know, does what she thinks is right in the moment, but she has no sense of righteousness. Like, you know, this should be done. This is the way. She's very much, you know, understanding of the unknown of it all. She's comfortable with the edge of death, which is great to play. There's a few awesome scenes near the end of season three where you really see that more edgy Buddhist aspect of her, you know, where she really searches for the edge and then feels the most comfortable there. She's a good person. She's just, you know, I want to say darker, but somehow there's a reality there that I think viewers can relate to. Most people are afraid to live, you know, in some of those harsher realities and have their feet on the ground. They try to avoid it, make it better. Maggie's like, no, man, this is just how it is.
Let's get on the edge and enjoy it. Now, of course, fans will have their own favorite characters. Apart from your own, are there any other in the show that you particularly identify with or just enjoy watching?
Yeah. There's something I identify with in all the characters. I think the show is well written in that sense. My favorite character, and I keep talking about Cochise, but it really is Cochise, because he has human qualities, and I think when you can achieve that in a sci-fi show, you know, explore life in general, what makes us empathetic and sort of root for someone, but how we're actually, you know, we are so different, and at the end of the day, it's just such a, it's a tricky subject to even talk about, right? Because it's like, you care for somebody, and then as soon as your life is threatened or your territory is threatened, the differences come out, and you can flip on a dime, you know? It's interesting, it's a nice way to look at why racism exists, or class wars, you know? It's a very cool metaphor.
Fascinating stuff. I'm conscious we have to let you go, but fans are going to want to know two things. First of all, is there anything else coming up for you at the moment? We're going to see you in anything else? And do you have a message for all the fans, particularly of Falling Skies, who can't wait for season three?
Okay. Yeah, I have a very cool job coming up. I'm going to Jakarta, Indonesia, to play the American assassin in an Indonesian blockbuster. And I'm so excited that I got this offer. I'm going to be the only English-speaking person on set. And it's called The Guardian, and my character's name is Paquita, and I guess they have hired me, you know, they wanted a motorcycle riding badass American assassin.
So they watched Falling Skies, they knew what they were getting.
So I get to go to Indonesia for 5 weeks on a big, lonely adventure. That's June 9th. So I'm going to miss this whole, like, launching of season three. I'm going to be on another planet, basically. I worked in China to do DOA.
Oh, of course.
And I swore that I wouldn't do anything like that again because it was so challenging. But here I go.
Back on the edge.
Yeah, and then to the fans, I just want to say keep watching and thank you so much. Some of the things that people say about Maggie really move me because I can tell that they're really feeling her.